Our next speaker is going to be a very distinguished person we have. I'm just going to read her profile. She's from the Department of Botany in University of Jaffna. And she is like a BSc honors she did in Jaffna University, then went on to do MPhil in and the PhD in Peradeniya University. She's very distinguished professor at Department of Botany, and she is going to present us today of varieties of mango available in northern Sri Lanka. This is none other than Dr. Naamahal Krishnapillai. Dr. Krishnapillai, all yours.
Yes, thank you for your introduction. I am not a professor, still senior lecturer. Not a professor, senior lecturer from Department of Botany. Can you see the slides?
Yes, but you can make full screen.
Full screen.
Yes. That's the button. Now, yeah. If you go, yeah, that's it.
Good evening, all of you. Under the title of Promoting Mango Cultivation in Northern Province, the title of my presentation is Varieties of Mango Available in Northern Sri Lanka. Mango varieties can be divided into two categories. Already everyone talked about that. Table or desert varieties and mango fruits for processing. This can be determined by the quality parameters such as color, firmness, taste, appearance, size, shape, total soluble solids, pH, titratable acidity, vitamin C content, disease incidence and severity, sabron injury, etc. Everyone likes to get or eat good quality mangoes. All of us are waiting here for getting good quality mangoes. For getting good quality mangoes, one of the most problem for mango growers is getting proper planting material for maintaining their fruit quality. For this, we have to encourage mango growers to select or buy mango varieties which have labeled from the Department of Agriculture. Overall quality can be maintained by these labels or certification. We should identify ways for providing planting material to all mango growers with labels only. I have seen the farm owners selling these planting materials without labeling. Then it give the fruits a different fruit quality. Then we have to maintain the quality of the fruit, we have to consider about the planting material. We have to distribute these planting material properly to the growers. I think Department of Agriculture already has taken the steps, and they have to consider this fact. Then, based on the varieties available in Northern Province, first one, our variety, that is Villar. Overall quality, based on the quality parameters, excellent one. Category, we can use this one, this Villar varieties as desert. Here, by using the crop management, especially irrigation, we can get Villar mangoes more than 500 gram. With this, we have to consider about crop management practices properly in the home garden levels also. This first variety, this one, Villar, overall quality excellent. Then Kilichonda, I think I got this variety from one of the home garden. overall quality excellent dessert category. Here the appearance after ripening, we can get pinkish red color. Appearance is very good, taste also excellent. The next one, Salem. Overall quality very good, category also dessert, we can use for processing also. Pandi, green mangoes. Overall quality very good. We are using these mangoes for processing. Usually green mangoes with salt and chili powder. Usually students, school students and others, they like this mango with salt and hot chili powder. And also I think we can promote these pandi mangoes for processing because it's a high yielding variety. Ambalagi mangoes, overall quality excellent, category dessert. Important thing of these Ambalagi mangoes, appearance is good, very less or low sabon injury, and during harvesting also if we consider proper maturity fruits, there is no latex exudation. Because of that, very low sabon injury and uniform smooth skin also there. Then that is also we can use for dessert varieties. Vairakandi, green mangoes, overall quality very good. These Vairakandi mangoes can be used for processing. Achidini mangoes, overall quality excellent. We can use these mangoes for a dessert or processing. During green mangoes, the specific features of these Pachidini, it gives sweet taste during mature fruits or green mangoes. After ripening, also taste of these fruits are very excellent. Unknown variety. This variety, I got this variety from a home garden. It looks like Salem, but the overall fruit quality parameters differed from Salem variety. Overall quality very good. We can use this variety for processing. Kulima, I think this is the oldest variety. Overall quality very good, category processing. I think everyone familiar with these mangoes. We are making dishes with this mango, right? Especially for string coppers with coconut milk, also we are calling sodi. This Pulima is very popular for preparing mango sodi. Karthakulamban, all of us talking about this Karthakulamban. But I found with proper maturity, I got yellow, dark yellow color fruit properly, and also Brix contain more than 24. That is compared to other mango varieties. When I worked at ITI, I found the highest Brix value was found for these Karthakulamban mangoes. I brought all these mangoes from Jaffna to ITI laboratory. Here Karthakulamban, overall quality excellent, category dessert. I think all the people at ITI have given all these varieties. My supervisor Dr. Wilson Vijayaratnam also tasted these fruits, and this is during 2013-12 to 14 period. I think a very difficult period. Peter Person, this is also one of the variety. Overall quality very good, introduced variety. Category, we can use these for processing. Hodima, I think I found a paper by Dr. Arasakesari. He found this variety and published, I think, in 2004. Then during my work, I found these Kodima mangoes are very juvenile stage and young. Some fruits were there. Then I got these fruits from a home garden. The problem is pest pest problem is a big problem, but during the mature green stage, it's a big fruit more than 900 gram, big fruit more than 900 gram from the home garden. Then after ripening, without the problem of pest, if we ripen this fruit, overall quality excellent, very big fruit. But however, because of these fruit, because of this pest problem, we can use these mangoes for processing. With proper management, we have to consider about this management. If we consider about proper management, we can use these Kodima as desert variety. Malgowai, I think I got this variety from Department of Agriculture, Tirunelveli. They are Malgowa mangoes. I got only 5 or 6 mangoes, very poor yield. This is also one of the introduced variety from, I think, India. Overall quality, very good. Category, we can use these for processing. Valle Columban, overall quality, very good. After ripening, it becomes light yellow. We can use these for processing, but after ripening, we can eat. We can take this fruit as dessert also. Neelam, I got this picture from Department of Agriculture. After ripening, this fruit also I found only 9 to 10 fruits from the tree during my research period. But after ripening, overall quality very good. We suggest that one for the based on the quality parameters, that category was on processing. The Bathalam 30 is very big fruit. This also found in agriculture. They didn't promote this variety. I don't know why, but very big fruit I found. That also very poor yield. Big fruit, overall quality very good. Category processing. Then here, based on the quality parameters, first thing, post-harvest pest disease and disorders of mango varieties. These varieties up to here, I have identified these varieties in Jaffna region, here susceptible to insect. Here, one of our oldest variety, very tasty, excellent in taste. It is susceptible to insect. That is the problem. If you overcome this problem of this insect by bagging, as Dr. Arasakesari said, we can promote this variety also. Excellent in taste with proper management. Then other varieties mostly resistant. Then Salem also susceptible for insect. Kodima also susceptible for insect. Then most susceptible diseases, right? Here also, Ambalavi mangoes, it is resistant for stem and rod. Then if you take among these varieties, based on the quality parameters of these pest and disease and sabal injury on the external appearance, latex during harvesting very low or nil, then sabal injury also very less. Disease problem, I think while buying the fruits from the market, you can see the black spot over all the skin, that is anthracnose, and it spread from the stem and pod, that is stem and rod. There are two major diseases. In addition to these, aspergillus rot also reported by us as first report in Sri Lanka with my supervisor, aspergillus rot. Then, if we overcome these diseases during our post-harvest management, we can maintain good quality fruit. Then, important thing is, if we harvest the fruit at proper maturity, I found we can get the disease incidence also, disease incidence and severity also very low, and we can get good quality fruits. Here, biochemical and quality characteristic of mango germplasm after ripening. Varieties are here. Breeds, here we can see that Karakalamban 22.5, Willard also 23.5, right, overall the mean value, right. Our desert varieties, they have high Breeds value. In Kodima also, during my study from the home garden, highest Breeds value. Then here, Briggs and Ryder, double acidity of pH balance between these two scientifically give the taste, and we can get taste or overall quality from the taste panel also. Then we can see all of our desert varieties are excellent in taste. Kodima also excellent in taste. Others we can use for processing. Very good overall quality based on these total soluble solid pH, disease incidence, urban injury, external appearance. Here is the edible portion. And all of these fruits, edible portion more than 72%, and highest edible portions are here for Karthikoluman mangoes. Storage life, we can see after harvesting, we can get, if you harvest proper maturity, we can get ripening fruit after 9 days. Karthikoluman, Salem also 9 days. Others here, Ambalavi 7 days, and so on. These are the basic biochemical and quality parameters of the varieties collected from Jaffna. Here, this table shows the fruit availability of different varieties of mango in Jaffna during this period. Here, we can see already I have told you this Ambalavi one available throughout the period, the January, February, and they have three seasons, and all throughout the year, we can get these Ambalavi. Then, with here from this January, we can get these fruits, right? March and August, right? Also, we can collect these fruits. During September, the off season, we can get only Ambalavi, Champatan, and Kodima. October, November, also our season, right? Then we can get most of the fruits. By proper maintaining of our varieties available in Jaffna or Northern Province, we can supply fruits throughout the year, right? Then we can say peak off season and major peak season, right? Off season also, with proper management of all these varieties, we can supply fruits for the market. Then I have to insist this crop management in northern region, because the home garden growers or mango growers in home garden, they didn't care about crop management. Just they grow the plant, or they plant that plant, right? And after that, they have no care about that. Then based on this, I think we have to arrange workshops or through AI, so whatever ways we have to identify the ways to give them the knowledge for crop management. I think already Department of Agriculture, they have some program. Anyway, I found those programs didn't reach 100% to the mango growers. Then mainly soil preparation, then fertilizer application, mainly now everyone towards organic farming. Then organic fertilizer, each and every home garden, we have organic fertilizer, all waste, our household waste and debris, leaves, everything, biofertilizers, green leaves, we have organic fertilizer, then we can use that. But the important thing is we have to consider about irrigation for getting good quality fruits. During the fruit set, we have to cut the irrigation, and after the marble size stage of the fruit, we have to irrigate. I have experience with this irrigation and got the fruit weight more than 500 gram in Villard varieties. Then pest and disease management, there is proper management is important. If we do properly soil preparation, fertilizer application, through with irrigation, we can manage pest and disease properly. Then I think Dr. Arasagirisari and Dr. Suresh Ellavala talked about this pruning, but we are not doing this pruning in our home gardens. Earlier, I think Mr. Niranjan told there are experts in pruning available in Jaffna, and I don't know the situation about now. Then we have to train the experts right, for pruning, and also we have to advise the mango home garden growers for proper management, crop management. Then post harvest management, I think my supervisor has a lot of experience about this post harvest management. Under these, I have to say a word, only the careful handling with proper maturity. Careful handling with proper maturity, we can get a good quality fruits. And summary of my talk, conservation of traditional varieties is important. We have to find mechanism for conservation. We have to think about in situ and ex situ cultivation of our traditional mango varieties. Mango planting materials with labels for certification of their quality are allowed for sale to maintain quality all over the northern province. In this case, I think Department of Agriculture, they are labeling the plants, but without label also planting materials are available in market. They have to prevent or ban the situation, and they have to give proper planting material for mango growers. Concerning good agricultural practices and crop management lead to get good quality mangoes, then home garden growers neglect this one, crop management, then they also should follow proper crop management. In the crop management, especially trained person for pruning and for identifying and confirming the maturity indexes for harvesting also important. If we allow the harvesters, they are getting mangoes from the hull 3,000, 4,000 or 3,000 like that. They harvest the hull plant a lot with immature mangoes, all mangoes at a time. That is not a good way for harvesting. Then we have to train person for pruning and also for identifying and confirming the proper maturity index for harvesting. Under this post-harvest management, I insist only the careful handling is important to maintain quality in each and every step of market chain. With this, I have to insist the conservation of traditional varieties and also proper crop management. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Namahal. We know how to eat, and I mean, I realize that there's so much going on before it comes to our table. I am really getting jealous of your job because, you're going to eat all that variety after every research you do. So we don't get that to see that. Thanks again, Dr. Namahal. Please save some mangoes for us.